Good morning, students. Today again we are going to start with the chapter Carbon and its compound, that is the chapter of chemistry. Now, continuing with the topic covalent bond formation by the carbon compounds. Now, formation of oxygen molecule. Now, as we know, the atomic number of oxygen is 8, so its electronic configuration is 2-6. Thus, oxygen has 6 electrons in L shell, that is valence shell. Therefore, it needs 2 more electrons to complete its octet. So, each atom of oxygen share 2 electrons with other oxygen atom to form a diatomic molecule of oxygen. By doing so, each oxygen atom acquire a stable electronic configuration of nearest noble gas, that is neon. The 2 electrons contributed by each oxygen atom give rise to 2 shared pair of electrons, and these 2 shared pair of electrons constitute a double bond between the 2 oxygen atom, which is represented by a double line. The 2 pairs of electron on each oxygen atom in O2 molecule which are not involved in bond formation are called as lone pair, and further since each oxygen atom share 2 electron to form O2 molecule. Therefore, the valency of oxygen is 2. In other words, oxygen is divalent. So, electron dot structure of oxygen molecule is, so there are 6 electrons in the 3 pair, and the 2 pair of electron will be shared by each oxygen atom. 1 pair of electron pair will be shared by each oxygen atom, forming 2 electron pair in the center. So since the 2 electron pair of oxygen are shared in center, so there is formation of double bond. Similarly, in nitrogen molecule, the atomic number of nitrogen is 7, so its electronic configuration is 2-5. Thus, nitrogen have 5 electrons in L shell, that is the valence shell. Therefore, it needs 3 more electrons to complete its octet as it has 5, so it requires 3 more. So, each atom of nitrogen share 3 electrons with other atom of nitrogen to form a diatomic molecule of nitrogen. By doing so, each nitrogen atom acquire a stable electronic configuration of nearest noble gas, that is neon. The 3 electrons contributed by each nitrogen atom give rise to 3 shared pair of electrons. And these 3 shared pair of electrons constitute a triple bond between the 2 nitrogen atoms, which is represented by a triple line. So there are 3 electron pair being shared in the center of nitrogen. As it requires 3 electrons, so 3 electrons are center, 2 here, 3 here and 2 here. So when these 3 are shared by each nitrogen atom, as 3 electron pair are shared, so there is formation of 3 bonds, that is a triple bond. So hence, the valency of nitrogen is 3. In other words, nitrogen is trivalent, and the electron dot structure of diatomic molecule of nitrogen is shown here. Now, what are hydrocarbons? Hydrocarbons are the parent compound or functional organic compound. All organic compound contain hydrogen along with carbon. Some organic compound also contain oxygen, halogen, and sometimes nitrogen and sulfur. We have discussed the formation of methane, which is a marsh gas, and in methane C is bonded to 4 atoms that I have shown earlier also. Covalent bond in methane, which we have discussed. So, carbon get 4 electron by sharing of 1 electron with each hydrogen atom. So, CH bond are formed and carbon atom is centrally placed. Bond formed by sharing of electron are known as covalent bond. as these bonds are known as the covalent bond. A single covalent bond formed by the sharing of two electrons. That I have told you, two electrons form a single single bond. Now the electron and dot and cross structure in the electrons of carbon are shown by X, that is a cross, and electrons of hydrogen are shown with a dot. So in this way we can represent the methane molecule. Okay. Now discussing about the properties of organic compound with covalent bond, they have low melting and boiling point. They are generally insoluble in water but are soluble in organic solvents. And they are poor conductor of heat and electricity. Now again the covalent bond in oxygen. Oxygen has 8 electron in valence shell. So configuration we have done. And we have 6 electron as we know in outermost shell. It required 2 more electron to complete its octet. And in this way oxygen form the, by sharing 2 electron each oxygen atom forms a double bond in between the 2 oxygen atoms, and double bond is represented by 2 single bonds lying one above another. Now what are saturated and unsaturated hydrocarbons? Saturated hydrocarbons are the carbon atom are linked to each other by the single bond. So when the carbon atoms they are linked to each other by single bond, then they are known as saturated hydrocarbons. And what are unsaturated hydrocarbons? Hydrocarbons in which carbon atoms are linked to each other by double or triple bond. Here is a double bond and triple bond I'll show you. So they are known as unsaturated hydrocarbons. Okay, it may be either a double bond or it may be either a triple bond. So this carbon is sharing single bond, so it is a saturated carbon, and this carbon is sharing double bond, so it is not a saturated carbon. Again, single bond, saturated, double bond, unsaturated. So when the carbon bond they have a single bond between two carbon atoms, then they are known as alkanes. And when the carbon atoms they have double bond between two carbon atoms, then they are known as alkenes. And the carbon atoms when they have a triple bond between them, then they are known as alkynes. Now saturated and unsaturated hydrocarbons can form straight chain or closed chain structure. These chains can have branches and cross links and are known as closed chain or ring compound. This is a straight chain shown here. This is a chain having a branch, means carbon is being substituted further. Okay. And this is a closed ring chain compound. Okay, straight chain, branch chain and closed chain compound. Now carbon has a very good property, that is catenation. So what is catenation? The remarkable property of carbon atom to form bond with itself and give rise to a single large structure or chain. So what is the definition? The property of direct bonding between the atoms of same element to form a chain. The carbon chain can be straight or branched, forming the large molecules. As I have shown you the examples earlier, that there may be straight chain between the carbon atoms, or any carbon can be substituted further to form the branch chain. So this is the versatile nature of carbon, the unique property of self-linking of carbon atom through covalent bond and form single straight or branch chain or rings of different size is catenation. Okay, From the above discussion, we can conclude that it is the maximum tendency of carbon for catenation which is responsible for existence of large number of carbon compound. And carbon show tetracovalency that we have discussed earlier, that carbon has valency of 4. So it is capable of bonding with 4 other atoms of carbon or the atoms of some other monovalent element. Due to its small size, the nucleus of carbon atom can hold its shared pair of electrons strongly. As a result, the bond that carbon form with most of the other elements such as hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen, sulfur, chlorine are very strong, thereby making these compounds exceptionally stable. This further increases the number of carbon compound. And also carbon has tendency to form multiple bond, maybe double bond, triple bond. Why? Again, due to its small size. Okay. And isomerism is one more property which is shown by carbon compound, which we'll discuss further.